Good morning. It is Lissy. It is Tuesday, September 6th, about 10 to 8. I'm running late. I was really tired. I didn't really sleep that well over the weekend. And then on Sunday, I mean, I slept okay, but like I was up in the middle of the night, you know, kind of tossing and turning. And so Sunday, Alicia and I went to Kennebunkport, which was so fun. Oh my God, I love it there. What a charming, like quintessential New England town. I took some videos, so I'll have to see how they came out, and I'll put them here at the end if they're, you know, anything worth seeing. Maybe even if they're not, and you can always turn it off if you don't want to watch it. But so we stayed at, it's called the Colony Hotel. It is beautiful because it's this old, large, white, historic building with this, I mean, gorgeous pool overlooking the beach is across the street, but the pool is right, you know, it sits up high and you can see from the pool straight to the water. We got there Saturday morning right around 11. We checked in, we walked into town, like, you know, poked around a little, had a nice lunch, came back, room was ready, like got our stuff, you know, settled into the room. And then we went and sat at the pool for a few hours. Like, it was sunny, not a cloud in the sky, bright blue skies, warm, but no humidity, like not hot at all. And we didn't bring bathing suits or anything because honestly, we expected it to be way chillier than what it was. But we just had a lovely, lovely afternoon. And then we went and sat out there. Like, so the hotel faces primarily west. So we went out to look at the, you know, the sunset and have a drink. And then we went in back into like the little town for dinner. And we came back and we had another drink and we sat in the lobby. So the lobby of the hotel is like, it's very old. It needs a redo. The room was really nice. The room looks like it's been redone, although it's still in that very like flowery, you know, New England-y style. The lobby definitely could use a redo, and the restaurants are like, you know, have gross, like dirty looking hotel carpet. But other than that, it was lovely. But we sat in the lobby. There had been a wedding at the hotel that day. So it was clearly a young wedding. I'm sure like maybe just right out of college, the people getting married. So lots of, you know, young people. So they were all going off for the evening, you know, to the bars after the wedding. They came home at 2 o'clock in the morning, and like first were like, you know, really loud in the hallway. And then one of them must have been right next door to us, and they had an outside porch. And so they were like out on the porch, like, you know, having a party basically at 2 o'clock in the morning. So I called downstairs, and so I was not the first person to have called, but you know, anyway, so the whole point of that nonsense is that I didn't sleep well. So yesterday I got home and I 9:30, I couldn't even keep my eyes open, and I, you know, didn't drag myself out of bed until a little after 7. So here I am, and I have to go to work. But anyway, I thought I'd do a quick outfit of the day, and I got a request to do like also my makeup of the day. So I thought we could do that quickly, you know, not in great detail, but like, so basically. Oh, and I always get questions. I have two pairs of reading glasses. These are from a store on Newbury Street called SEE, and it's their brand. And their frame's my prescription, you know, that they put in. But anyway, so today I used, for makeup, I used the Tom Ford Burnished Amber Eye Color Quad. And this is old. I don't know that it's still available, but I will show you something similar. I'm pretty sure Charlotte Tilbury has a very similar one. If not, like some of my Vizart palettes have like very similar colors. But I basically did the light color all over my lid, this brownish color in the crease, and then I used this like deep purple, like kind of to line. And then today I used the L'Oreal Voluminous Mascara, which I actually really like. And then I also used what I use every day, bronzer, my Laura Mercier Bronze 04, and then the Highlight 01. And then On the lips, I am wearing Tom Ford Spanish pink. Just a really light pink. So that is that. And then I'm wearing, so it's chilly out. This is that Erdem jacket that I bought that I showed you in my recent like major haul. I'm wearing 3 Hermes bangles, a Chanel necklace. This is like a Vince satiny tee. I'm wearing J. Crew pants, a Moschino belt, and these are like some Chanel Oxfords. So that's pretty much like the getup for today. And what else? That might be it. After we left Kennebunkport yesterday, so I got a zip car. And yesterday morning when we got into, after we went, I'm forgetting so many things. So we went out for a really long walk yesterday morning over to the Bush compound. You know, they invited us in. No, you couldn't even get anywhere close. You know, they have like a little guardhouse and all that. But it's a really lovely walk. There are all these beautiful, like very large, gorgeous homes along the water there. And then, you know, we just kind of wanted to like take a peek at the Bush compound. It's just, you know, it really made me think, you know, no matter what your politics are, or no matter whether you like any president that we've had or not, that family has 2 men that served this country. Actually, I shouldn't even say men. I mean, 2 people that served as presidents, but their families served as well, because there's huge sacrifices to be made by anybody who is in that office. And I just feel like, you know, I really appreciate the fact that there are people out there willing to do that job, because it has got to be like the hardest job in the world. So that's my public service announcement for the day. But anyway, we went on that lovely walk. We went back to the hotel. We had spotted this really cute little French bakery. Maybe it was called like a Morning in Paris or something. So we were going to get in the car and go over there. And then we got in the car and it gave me this message like that the tire pressure was low. And God, I mean, neither Alicia nor I had any idea what we're doing. So we pull into this gas station. I go inside. We ask the guy, like, you know, how do we even know? So he showed us how to use the little machine. But, you know, we're clearly clueless. Like, I feel like we're all humans here. Could you not have offered to help? So we futzed around with it, couldn't figure out what we were doing. So I went back in and I literally said, do you think you can come help me just for a couple minutes and show me how to work this thing? Because I'm not sure that what I'm doing is working. So he did. We filled up the tires. We got in the car. It still gave me that stupid message. But meanwhile, while we were filling up the tires, one of the locals was hanging out. Oh, let me just also say that this guy, he was not busy at all. He was inside smoking a cigarette, which I'm sure you're not allowed to do. And then outside at the gas station, which I am sure is unauthorized. Like, I'm not sure smoking a cigarette where a gas pump is very smart. But anyway, while we were out there, one of the locals, he kind of cackled at me. He's like, the air, because we had to put quarters in to get air. He's like, the air down the road is free. And I was like, oh, thank you so much. I'm like, nobody else bothered to tell me that. He was like, yeah, come back next year. I'm sure to breathe will charge you. So clearly he was not a fan of paying for air. So anyway, when we got in the car and saw that the tires were still low, there was the place where the air was up the road, which actually had like full service gas station. So some young guy helped us. And like, apparently the tires, we overfilled the back tires. We underfilled the front tires, whatever. But we drove home. We drove through Ogunquit on the way home. There's lots of traffic between Kennebunkport and Ogunquit. It took us like an hour. I think it's like it's not many miles. It couldn't be more than 5 or 10 miles. And then we had a lovely lunch outside. And then we drove home. It took us like 2 hours home. But just getting out of Maine took a ton of time. And then it was kind of smooth sailing after that. So anyway, so that was my long weekend. And I think that's it. I hope you've had a wonderful weekend. And I will see you soon. Bye. Okay, I realized I forgot to show you. I'm carrying this Balenciaga bag today, the light pink. Because this, you might remember, or you might not. But this jacket has some like very pale pinks in it. So I didn't show you that and I wanted to. So now have a great day. Bye.
Nobody will care about the stuff in the video. Yeah, I like the little sitting chairs.
Oh my God, it's so cute. I mean, the room is way nicer than the lobby.
The room is definitely nicer than the lobby because it's so bright.
I was a wee bit nervous.
I was too, but this is like actually quite lovely.
Did you get the potty already?
Yeah. And the giant closet. Nice place to have mass.
Well, see, I think this is the Bush's house.
This?
I think it is.
It's such a pretty church.
Oh, yeah, I have tons of pictures of this.